Travis was a hard worker. All through school, he was a standout on the baseball teams. He excelled in his work and academics. Travis became successful in business, rising within a company of which he ultimately became CEO. He had a lovely family. He was success personified. Travis was a hard worker, but he couldn't understand why his wife wanted a divorce. Had he become too focused on himself?
I want to live my life closer to thee.
Life in our culture has formed and shaped our thinking and feelings and our actions. We've come to focus on ourselves, on our own personal needs and wants and desires. But what about those closest to us? What about spouse and children? And what about Jesus Christ? Without too much effort, we fall into selfish, self-centered lives, a lifestyle that our culture promotes and supports. The life of Jesus, though, shows us not a pattern of a selfish, self-centered life. It shows us the pattern of sacrifice, that is, setting aside personal pleasures and desires and looking to the needs of others. Jesus said of himself, "For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord." Jesus humbled himself for you and me. He sacrificed himself on the cross for our forgiveness, for our life and salvation. That's the great love he has for you. As followers of Christ, that great love is our motivation to sacrifice for him, to live a sacrificial life for him. But we fail. We live for ourselves, for our job and career, our entertainment and pleasure, our interests and hobbies. We care for ourselves first and foremost, often to the exclusion of others. Are you living faithfully for Jesus? Are you living sacrificially for your spouse and family? Is the love of Christ motivating your life? Thankfully, the perfect sacrifice of Jesus on the cross covers our sin and our selfishness. And his resurrection restores us to abundant life in him. "I came," he said, "that they may have life and have it abundantly." Thanks be to God for the hope and love he's given us in Jesus. Pray with me. Lord Jesus, forgive me for my selfish, self-centered life. Help me learn sacrifice from your life and cross, and restore me to abundant life in you. Amen.
Thanks for joining us. If you're seeking services for symptoms of mental illness, please talk to your primary doctor or a health professional. Don't have one? Consider one of the resources listed here to find help. And God's peace to you.